Welcome to an introduction to symmetry about the x-axis, y-axis, and the origin using points. Let's begin by considering these four points on the coordinate plane. More specifically, let's begin by considering point A and point D. Notice how if we were to fold this graph across the x-axis or the horizontal axis, notice how point A and point D would match up perfectly. And therefore, we can say that point A and point D have x-axis symmetry or are symmetrical across the x-axis. It's also true if we were to take point A and reflect it across the x-axis, it would be point D, and if we reflect point D across the x-axis, it would be point A. So once again, these two points have symmetry across the x-axis or have x-axis symmetry. We can also say they're reflections across the x-axis. If we look at the coordinates of these two points, notice how the x-coordinates are the same, but the y-coordinates are opposites. Now let's consider point A and point B. Notice how if we were to fold this graph across the y-axis, point A and point B would match up perfectly, and therefore these two points are symmetrical across the y-axis, or we say they have y-axis symmetry. It's also true if we reflect point A across the y-axis, it would become point B. If we reflect point B across the y-axis, it would become point A. If we take a look at the coordinates of these two points, notice how in this case the y-coordinates are the same, but the x-coordinates are opposites. And this is always true when we have a reflection across the y-axis. Now let's consider point A and point C. These two points are considered reflections across the origin. Notice if we start with point A, reflected across the x-axis from here to here, and then reflected again across the y-axis, it would be point C. So when we take a point and reflect it across the x and y-axis, we say it's a reflection across the origin, or the two points have symmetry about the origin. Another way to think of this is if we were to sketch a segment where point A and point C were the endpoints, and then we rotate this 180 degrees about the origin from here to here, notice how the two points would match up perfectly, which would always be true if we have symmetry about the origin or if we reflect the two points about the origin. So we say point A and point C have symmetry about the origin. So to summarize, if we have two points and the x-coordinates are equal and the y-coordinates are opposites, then we have symmetry about the x-axis. If the x-coordinates are opposites and the y-coordinates are the same, then we have symmetry about the y-axis. And finally, if the x-coordinates are opposites and the y-coordinates are opposites, we have symmetry about the origin. Which means if we're given a single point, we want to reflect the point about the x-axis, we replace y with negative y, or change the sign of the y-coordinates. If we want to reflect the point about the y-axis, we replace x with negative x, or change the sign of the x-coordinates. And to reflect a point about the origin, we replace x with negative x and y with negative y, or we change the sign of the x and y-coordinates. So let's take a look at an example. We're given a point on the coordinate plane and asked to find the coordinates of the point after it is reflected across the x-axis, y-axis, and the origin. So notice the given point has coordinates negative 3, 5. So to visualize this, if we reflect this point across the x-axis, or reflect it across this horizontal axis, the point would go from here to here. Notice how the coordinates of the new point would still have an x-coordinate of negative 3, but now the y-coordinate would be negative 5, which is the same as replacing y with negative y or changing the sign of the y-coordinate to reflect the point across the x-axis. So the coordinates would be negative 3, comma, negative 5. To reflect the given point across the y-axis or across the vertical axis, the point would go from here to here. Notice how the coordinates of the point would now be 3, comma, 5. So when reflecting across the y-axis, notice how we change the sign of the x-coordinate and left the y-coordinate the same, which is what our notes say, replacing x with negative x. So for the reflection across the y-axis, the new coordinates would be 3, 5. And then finally, to reflect across the origin, we take the given point, reflect it across the x-axis and then the y-axis, which would be from here to here, and then from here to here. So notice how the new coordinates would be 3, 5. Comparing this to the original point, notice how we change the sign of the x-coordinates and the y-coordinates. So the new coordinates would be 3, negative 5. And our notes say replace x with negative x and replace y with negative y, which we did by changing the sign of both coordinates. But I do also want to mention that if we reflect a point across the origin, that would be the same as taking the original blue point and rotating it 180 degrees about the origin from here to here. I hope you found this helpful.